Hello everyone, welcome to Laravel 9 series, and in this series we are going to create multi-vendor e-commerce website. So in this video we are going to take complete overview of the multi-vendor e-commerce website. We are going to see that what steps we are going to take in future videos, and we are going to see examples as well as features of multi-vendor e-commerce website. Okay, so let's start. So first thing is, I want to tell you that this is the part 0 of the Laravel 9 tutorial. If someone already know about multi-vendor e-commerce website, then that person can skip this video. But I suggest everyone to watch this video so that we must know that what we are going to do in future videos. Okay, so we have done so far basic and advanced e-commerce series. And this multi-vendor e-commerce website covers both basic, advanced, as well as the multi-vendor feature. So first of all, I'm going to explain you that what is the difference between basic and multi-vendor e-commerce website. So see, we have done the basic e-commerce so far. And in basic e-commerce, I'm going to tell you, there are some users, and this is the website. So users are directly interacting with the website for placing the orders. Okay, so this is the kind of structure. So these are the users. Okay, so this is the business to consumer. Consumer here is the user, and this website is the client website. This is, we call the business. Okay, so users are directly interacting with the website, and they are going to place the order on the website, and the client itself is responsible for adding the products. So client is adding the products in the website, in the basic e-commerce website. Okay, so here the client is going to add the products in the website, and users are going to place orders for these products. Okay, so this is the direct relation between users as well as the website. So this is the direct connectivity between the users and the website. So we call it as business to consumer. Okay, so what happened in multi-vendor website? I will explain you that what's new in multi-vendor website. So yeah. So in multi-vendor website, what's happening? This is our website, or we called it as business. So multi-vendor website is also business to consumer and business to business as well. Okay, it supports both business to consumer as well as business to business. So now here, in the same way, users are connecting with the website. Okay, user can directly place order on the website. But here the difference is, client is not going to add the products, but there are some vendors, we can also call it as sellers. So sellers are going to add the products on the website, on the business. Okay, so see, these vendors are going to interact with the website, and users will also interact with the website, but the vendors are going to add the products to the website. Okay, this is our website, and users are going to purchase. So these are the vendors and these are the users. Okay, so vendors are going to add the products and users are going to purchase those products. Okay, so this is the business to consumer. See, business to consumer, and this is the business to business. Here the relation is business to business. Okay, so this is the concept of multi-vendor e-commerce website, like Amazon used to do it. Okay, Amazon, you can see there are many types of products. You can see electronic products, clothing products, okay, mobiles, laptops, everything you can find there. Even the stationary products are there. So there is every kind of product is there. So all the products are not added by the Amazon itself. So there are many vendors registered there in Amazon who used to add the products in Amazon, and Amazon going to charge them. Okay, so business is going to charge them few bucks. Okay, like 5% charges or something. So up to business if they want to charge the vendors or not. Okay, So this is the business to business. I'm going to explain you with the another example. Okay, so another example I want to give you here, like you will go to some mall. Okay, so here it is, it is the mall, and in mall you are going to see several shops are there. Okay, so there is the electronic shop, there is the clothing shop, okay, there is the computer related shop, and there is stationery shop. Okay, so what you are going to do, you are going to purchase from this shop, this shop, this shop, this shop separately. Okay, same thing we are going to do in the multi-vendor e-commerce website. You are going to open the website, that is, that website is having having the categories. Okay, like electronics categories, clothing categories. Okay, so it's the same kind of thing. So here it is the mall, and here the website. Okay, and in website you are going to see every type of category, every type of brand, every type of products. Okay, so these shops, see, this is kind of shop, like if we will say like one person is opening one shop, one electronic shop in the website. Okay, so main thing is that whatever we are doing manually, we are going to convert that to the website. Okay, whatever we have seen in mall, we are going to convert that to the website. Okay, so suppose that mall owner hire some company to develop a website so that they can shift their entire business online. Okay, so see, here the multi-vendor e-commerce website comes into play. So this multi-vendor e-commerce website best suitable for those persons who are having some kind of departmental store, who are having some kind of malls, or also for those persons who want to create a website and want to invite the vendors and want to invite the users. They are going to invite the vendors for adding the products, and they are going to invite the users to purchase those products, to buy those products online. Okay, so multi-vendor website is helpful for everyone. So like the COVID is going on around the world, so any person can make their entire store online. Okay, so so nowadays these multi-vendor stores, multi-vendor websites are on a big demand, and as a developer, if you are going to choose this multi-vendor e-commerce line, you are going to choose this Laravel and going to create this multi-vendor e-commerce website, then I am sure that you are going to get many opportunities of freelancing, opportunities of joining some good development company, because you are going to create the multi-vendor e-commerce website, and there are many owners, many clients who wants this multi-vendor e-commerce website. And this e-commerce website we are going to do in the next few months. Okay, so we are going to create the complete multi-vendor e-commerce website. So now I'm going to tell you the features and its steps that we are going to do in this multi-vendor e-commerce website. I hope that it's clear to you. Up till now, it's clear to you that what is multi-vendor e-commerce website. Multi-vendor e-commerce website is a platform for third-party sellers to sell in one place. In simple terms, we can say it is a big store that contains various small shops that are run by individual vendors. Okay, so e-commerce website like Amazon or eBay are the good examples of multi-vendor websites where multiple vendors are allowed to register on a single platform with the same shopping cart and sell their products. So this multi-vendor website we are going to create that can handle both business to business as well as business to consumer. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you the steps here, some of these steps, and I'm going to I can do it like this. Okay, So this one I can do. Now here I am going to add some features or steps. Okay, steps. So see here, there are vendors. I have told you that in e-commerce, in basic e-commerce, we have seen there are users, okay, and admins. Okay, there are two only, users and admins. And now in multi-vendor e-commerce website, in multi-vendor, what will happen? There are users, okay, there are vendors, okay, now vendors come and admins are also there. Okay, so these vendors are the new term that we are going to cover in multi-vendor e-commerce website. So main thing is vendors are here now. So vendors are the shopkeepers, vendors are the dealers, okay, who are going to add products into our e-commerce website. Okay, so first thing is multi-vendor e-commerce website allows the vendors to register on the website. Okay, they are going to register on website. So so client can give them the free or paid membership. So it's up to the client, free or paid membership to them. Okay, so this is the first thing. They can register on the website with free or paid membership. Okay, so the next one is they can upload the products. Okay, they are going to upload the products. Okay, they will create their shops there. Okay, they will create their shops and upload the products, like if the vendor belongs to the electronic, if the vendor is having the electronic shop, they are going to upload the electronic products there. Okay, so like I have told you, owner can charge small fees. Owner charge small fees on the orders or on the registration. Okay, on orders also some percentage will go to the owner, the client. Okay, on owners or registration. Okay, so they are going to charge fees from them, some percentage. Okay, only then the owner, that client, is going to allow the vendors. Okay, so we also call them sellers as well. Okay, vendors, sellers are the same thing. Now we are going to look into admin features, that what admin can do. So here I will. So admin. So see, admin will monitor everything. Admin will monitor vendors. Admin will monitor users. Okay. So see, admin is going to approve the vendor. Like if vendor going to register on the website, so admin will approve those vendor. Admin will approve. Okay. So admin will approve vendors. Okay. So next one is, admin will also approve their products. Admin can also approve their products. What vendor is going to add? So admin will approve those products. See, they are not going to directly become live. Maybe the images are wrong. Maybe the product description is wrong. So admin will approve the vendors. Admin will approve the products. Okay. So, and the third one is, admin is going to check for the orders. Okay, admin is going to check for the order, is going to check orders. Okay, whatever orders are coming. Okay, so admin is going to track for these orders. Okay, and admin is responsible for the transactions. Okay, transactions, and that how much amount needs to give to the vendors, how much amount they will keep themselves. So these are the kind of things that admin is going to do. And also admin is going to approve the category request. Okay, categories, admin is going to check for the categories that the vendors are want in their multi-vendor e-commerce website. Okay, so these are the features of the admin that admin is going to do in our multi-vendor e-commerce website. Okay, so I will briefly explain you once again that we are going to cover this multi-vendor e-commerce website, where vendors are there, where users are there. Users are going to interact with the website. They are going to assess the website. They are going to purchase the products from the website, and vendors are going to add the products in the website, and admin is going to approve those products. Okay, so admin is also here, the client. Okay, so client is going to approve, okay, whatever the products the vendors are going to add in the website. So Amazon is a good example, a live example. We can see Amazon, we can register there, we can add our products there. They may charge for every order, they may charge for the registration as well. Okay, so it depends upon the client to client, if they want to charge, if they want to give the free access to the vendors. And after that, the steps that the vendor going to register, the admin going to approve, so it will work like this. Okay, so I hope this overview will help you to know that what we are going to do in the next few months. Okay, so we are going to do this in Laravel 9, and we are going to be the first one to create the website in Laravel 9. Okay, so hope that we are going to create a really good website in Laravel 9 without having any issues. Okay, so let's wait for the part 1. In the part 1, we are going to install Laravel 9, and also we are going to install that authentication and other few things so that we can start working on the multi-vendor e-commerce website. We are going to merge a very good admin template for our Laravel 9 that we are also going to review in our next video. So stay tuned for that. That's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.